What a glorious day for science, for humanity, and for each and every one of us present here today. It is with immense joy and a deep sense of honor that we open the doors of this place, dedicated to healing and the rebirth of the human race. This asylum is not merely a medical institution, it is a sanctuary, an oasis where those who suffer have refuge, hope, and above all, the chance to become humanity. That walks through these doors, I guarantee, will be transformed, restored, and stronger than ever before. But now, we heal. We give back to the spirit that life has taken from them. And it is with immense pride that I declare, here, everyone will come back here. Ladies and gentlemen, today marks the beginning of a new era. Let us be witnesses of this revolution, the architects of a world where healing the mind is no longer a dream, but a tangible reality.
I noticed a curious thing. He was mumbling something, even while immersed in this artificial sleep. Coherent words, just sounds, like he was trying to speak. I mentioned it to the doctor, but he didn't seem to mind a minor side effect, he told me. Said, still, I can't help but have a bad feeling.
everything is slipping away from me. This isn't just a medical error. It's something bigger, something darker. My patients are not in a therapeutic sleep. They are trapped somewhere between life and death. And they are no longer just mechanically animated bodies. Their minds are elsewhere, and something else has taken their place. I hear their voices at night, in my dreams. They call to me, M. Akeem. I can't reverse what I did. But it's too late. And soon, me too. Everything is slipping away from me. This isn't just a medical error. It's something bigger, something darker. My patients are not afraid to escape. They're trapped somewhere between life and death.
Ugh.